Hey, trying to put everything I've learned about simplifying and organizing Lightroom libraries is tricky. Choosing what to do is as important as what you choose not to do because some of the features in the destination panel can really trip you up. So I choose not to use them until after I'm done importing and back in the library. Let's get started. Now that we've reviewed the source panel and the image preview area, let's start a new library from the very beginning so that you can see how I set up Lightroom to import from start to finish. I've got Lightroom open in my current catalog. Go to File, New Catalog, and this will open a window where you can save your new Lightroom catalog. I put mine in the Pictures folder because that's the best place for it, not on your desktop. I'm naming my catalog Lightroom Guy Demo Import. You can name yours as you wish. And once you do this, select Create. And you'll notice here, now this is on my Finder or in the Explorer if you're on a PC, that in my Pictures folder I now have a new folder called Lightroom Guy Demo Import. And in there are my Lightroom catalog. That's my Lightroom catalog information. And the catalog, the actual basic catalog, is called Lightroom Guide Demo Import .lrcat. Anything with .lrcat is a Lightroom catalog. And that's what you're looking at. That's behind my Finder window. Now that we've saved our catalog, we can start to import. Lower left-hand side, your import button. You'll notice here that where it says select a source, there's nothing yet. I forgot to plug in my memory card. As soon as I plug in my memory card, boom, there it is. That's it. I'm going to select it. Now I'm just double checking to make sure eject after import is selected, that all photos are selected, and copy is selected. And I'm making sure that everything in here is checked. All right, it's a new import, so nothing here has been imported before. Now, before I do anything else, I'm going to go to this pull-down window, and I'm going to choose Other Destination. And Other Destination is going to be my starting point because that's where I want my pictures to go. Now, I have a dedicated external hard drive for my library. If you don't, put yours in the picture folder where you saved your library just a minute ago. Once you've selected the hard drive, your new hard drive, or your pictures folder, just select Choose, bottom right, and now up at the top, 2 reflects where your destination is for your files. In my case, it's the LR hard drive. You'll notice down by destination, it's also been selected. Yours would say pictures if that's what you had chosen. So now that we've selected our hard drive, let's take a look at the file handling panel and the build previews pull-down menu. Now I could go over each of these particular features, minimal, embedded in sidecar, standard, but really choose one-to-one. With one-to-one, you'll be making full resolution previews so that when you zoom in and look at details, you won't have to wait for Lightroom to build them on the fly. It's a really good choice, and it will really speed your workflow along. Now right below your build previews is build smart previews. Smart previews allow you to work on images when you don't have that hard drive connected to your computer. If you're working with a laptop and you're keeping your files on a hard drive, an external hard drive, Build Smart Previews will allow you to crop and make changes, and these will be applied to your images when you reconnect that external hard drive. Now, Don't Import Suspected Duplicates was covered in the previous edition of the Lightroom Library Mystery. You keep that checked so that you don't bring in duplicates. And make a second copy too. Now this is for backing up your pictures while you're importing them if you have another external hard drive. If you're importing to your pictures folder and you have one external hard drive, you can select this box, navigate to that drive, select it, and you will be backing up while you import your pictures to 2 different locations. If you happen to have your files on an external hard drive to begin with, you would need a second external hard drive. Now you're going to think I'm totally mad, but completely ignore the file renaming panel. Just leave it alone. It's another opportunity to mess things up. Trust me on this one. You can name your photos later if you wish, just not here and not now. And the same thing holds true for the Apply During Import panel. The Develop Settings, leave it alone. You can develop your pictures while you're in Lightroom. The metadata, on the other hand, is something you could fill out. However, it's fairly complicated, or at least it's complicated looking. And I'm going to save this for a future edition of the Lightroom guy, and I'll further explain that so that it doesn't seem so overwhelming. So for the time being, just cancel this, and we're not going to fill out the metadata at the moment. But keywords now. Now keywords is something we could do. And that's because keywords make our images searchable in the Lightroom library. So when you've got a group of pictures that have all been shot in the same place, you can keyword them as a group. If they're from two different places, you can't separately keyword two different groups of pictures on the import. Those will have to be keyworded once you're in the library. And in this case, everything in this group of imports are from Barcelona, Spain. If I had Barcelona and I had Madrid, I'd have to do that separately in the library. So let's leave the develop settings and the metadata alone, keywording when you can. And now, which has become for many of us the panel of grief, the destination panel. Okay, so I'm going to ask you to take a leap of faith on this one, and here's what I want you to do. Because if you do this, this will be the beginning of a library that really works for you. And I'm not going to go into any explanations other than this dating system that you're going to choose will keep your folder name short, and that will leave room for adding to the folder name once you've imported and you are back in the Lightroom library. On the left side of the top of the destination panel, you'll see a plus and a downward facing arrow. Now, it's going to look like it's going to let you create a new folder, but when you click on this, you're going to see you have an option for viewing all folders or affected folders only. When you choose affected folders, you're only going to see the destination. So in this case, we picked the hard drive. If you pick the pictures folder, then you would see the pictures folder. If you have multiple hard drives, this makes knowing where your pictures are going easier and clearer. Let's continue looking at the top part of the destination panel. Now we have into subfolder, which we're going to look at in a second, and we have organized by date, and we have the choice of putting it into one folder. We want by date. And this will give you your files and folders by year and date when we choose the date format. And the date format we're going to choose is this very top one. It's year. And then in a subfolder, we will have month and day. And this creates folders inside your destination that you've chosen in pictures or in your hard drive. It's going to create a year folder and then subfolders with month and date. The small plus next to each folder means that's a new folder it's going to create. Now, into subfolder, that's where we get into trouble because subfolder is going to add an extra unnecessary folder in most cases. And you'll see here I'm adding new folder. And you'll see that all of a sudden that 2014 folder is in another folder called new folder. And this just adds to the complication of trying to keep our files organized. So don't check into subfolder. It's only going to make things more complicated. And as long as you don't touch that hard drive selection that you choose at the very beginning or your pictures folder, you'll always only have one year folder and you'll be adding date and month folders. And now that we've got everything set up, let's make sure we can get to it every time without having to set it up again and again by going to the import preset pull down. If you pull down the menu here, you'll see that you have an option to save current settings as a new preset. Once you do that, you're always going to be able to call back everything that you've done. I'm calling mine LRG Import Preset. I'm going to click Create. And now from this point on, whenever I come into my Lightroom Import dialog, all I need to do is choose my Lightroom Import Preset. I'm my LRG import preset that I've just named, and it's going to take everything I've done, file handling, renaming, apply during import, and especially my destination folder. And that means that Lightroom is going to put my pictures into my destination in the right way every time, whenever I have that preset selected. And that's the magic to keeping your library in order. Go ahead, click import, and now we're on our way to building a stable library that will be consistent from import to import. And as you can see on the left-hand side under folders, we now have a folder with the year, and new folders are being added with the month and date the pictures were taken. It's very organized, it's very clean, and as you continue to import, you'll continue to have an organized library. And when it comes to getting down to the fun of developing your pictures in Lightroom, nothing helps more than having a well-organized library. This is Lightroom Guy. Thanks for watching.